Hi guys, welcome to the channel. Welcome back to another video. So a beginner level tutorial for all the web designer developers and who are starting newly to understand Google Search Console. So let me give you an introduction about Google Search Console. So Google Search Console is one of the most important tool for search engine optimization. If you are looking to drive organic traffic to your website, then you will have to install Google Search Console on your website, which is really important, which is how Google understands about your website. Through this tool, you submit your sitemap. Through this tool, you let the Google understand about your website, that which URLs you are about to crawl and what are the insights, which keywords you are getting traffic through Google search on your website. And there are a lot of other insights and reports, which I'm going to go over with you guys in this video, and give you in detail about how you can use the reports, how you can improve search engine optimization of your website using this tool, how can you read the reports. Also, I'm going to show you guys how you can install Google Search Console in your WordPress website and in your Shopify website, as these are the two popular CMS which I cover in this YouTube channel most of the time. So without further ado, let's dive into the screen where I'm going to show you guys the reports of my own website. So as you can see on my screen, we have the Google Search Console report of websensepro.com, which is our company website. And you can see we have this 12,000 total web search clicks. So these clicks does not include the social media traffic. It only shows you the traffic which is coming through Google search organically. Even if you're using Google paid ads, it's not going to show the traffic in this report. So all you have is completely organic traffic, right? Now let's click on Search Console Insights to see what our Google Search Console have to tell us about our website, right? So this is our Search Console Insights, and it's giving us that how many clicks we got in last 28 days. So that's our performance of last 28 days that we got clicks from Google search. Again, it's going to show only the Google search. It's not going to show the paid ads, or it's not going to show the social media traffic or any direct traffic. It just shows the Google search traffic. And it's showing a 0% increase, meaning it's the same as the last 28 days. We didn't got any decline. Neither we got any increase in number of clicks. So that's the growing content, where we can see that how to change header, menu, font size. This block, specific blocks, got 33 more clicks, which is 150% more than the previous 28 days. Similarly, this one got to a 29% more clicks than the previous 28 days. And here we have more reports like this. So these are our growing content, which we can focus on improve further. We can improve, we can add more content. We can add more headings on these content to improve our content further, right? And that's the popular content where we are getting most of the click. So we get 183 clicks on this blog post, 176 clicks on our main website, and 139 clicks on this blog post. So here's all of the traffic which I'm showing you guys I'm getting from Google search organically. It does not include any other traffic. It just includes the Google search traffic. And now it's telling us how people are finding us. So these are the most search queries of our website. So we are showing up on top 5 results. Our position in Google search is number 1 when someone searches for a brand name. Again, that's also a branded keyword. And that's something which is a generic how-to keyword, where we are showing up on 2.6, meaning sometime we show up on the third position of the Google search, and sometime we shows up on the second position. Similarly here, sometime we shows up on the third position and sometime we shows up on a fourth position for this specific keyword. So here are all of the keywords, and it's giving us this trophy where we are showing on top 5 results. Cool, right? So that's our Search Console insight. Now let's click on full report and see what are the insights we have on that full report. So guys, that's our full report. And you can see it's updated last 5 hours ago. And it's showing us how many clicks we got in last 3 months, how many impressions we got, and which is our CTR. So let me explain you what is the CTR. The CTR is click-through rate. So if one person is clicking on every 100 view, like if someone searched for a query and our website shows 100 times, and out of those 100 search queries, one of the searcher clicks on the website, it's going to be a 1% click-through rate. So that's how it's going to count the impression. And one impression equals to when someone searched for the query, and on the search result, our website shows up for once. That's one impression. So every 100 impression, if we get one click, it's going to be the 1% CTR, which is the click-through rate. Now we have multiple options to filter the report. If we want to, so if we click on date, we can select last 7 days. We can filter the report last 28 days, 3 months, and we have data for last 16 months. We can also compare the data. So if we want to see the difference of last 28 days with the previous 28 days, we can simply compare it. So I'm going to click on compare and compare the last 28 days to previous period. We can compare the 7 days, 3 months, 6 months, 7 days, and we have these options, right? So let's compare the last 28 days to previous period. Click on apply. And here, you can see that previously we got 3.5k clicks, but last 28 days we got 10 more clicks, which is 3.51k. Similarly, we got 184k impressions, but our impressions got down. So we can see that we got 4,000 less impressions. Our CTR is same. Our position also got a little bit down from 38.9 to 39.3. So this is an average position for every single keyword. And if I scroll down, you can see that we are seeing which query got us how many clicks. So our branded keyword, which is our main keyword, which is the website name, got 123 clicks in the last 28 days. And in the previous 28 days, it got 138 clicks. So we can see the difference that we got 15 clicks less than in the last 28 days if we compare it from the previous 28 days. Similarly, we can compare all of the keywords here. Like here we got 3 clicks increased. Here we got 1 click increased. Here we got 7 clicks down for this query. So all of these queries are showing up detailed analysis of how many clicks we got for each query. Other than this date feature, we also have this search type. So it's going to give us different results on different platform. So for example, web is completely a Google search. So if you go to google.com, these are the search results. So for example, if I type in one of my keywords, you can see that my website is showing up on the third page result. And this is the Google search, which is this one, the web, right? Now the image is for this images. Now if we go to images, we can see further results, right? Similarly, we can just filter out the web and check only the images, that how many clicks we got in our website when someone was searching for the images. So that's the result for the images. So we got 65 clicks in last 28 days as compared to the previous 28 days, which was 47 clicks. And when I scroll down, I can see that which queries or which keywords were responsible for getting the traffic from the image only, right? Similarly, we have video, which is the YouTube. You can see we didn't get any result from YouTube itself. And we have also news. So news is an app from Google, which you might have on your Android and iOS phones, which shows the different news result. My website is a blog and not the news, not getting any clicks from the news site, right? Now let's talk about the filter. I'm gonna go to the last 28 days report in my web. And now I can filter out the results based on the URL, and there are multiple other filters. So if I want to filter one single query, I can simply search that by adding the query. So I'm just going to click on query and let's add in WP Engine SSH, which is one of the keyword being searched for my website. You can see I didn't got any clicks on this keyword, but we have other keywords here. So if I click on any of the keywords from here, it's going to automatically add that on the filter. So here's the keyword. So you can see that it added that query to my filter, and now I can see the result for that specific query. We can also add a specific URL as a filter. So if I want to see the search clicks only for one specific page, one specific URL, I can do that as well. So I'm gonna add the page, which is my main website. Now it's showing me that the main page of my website got 3.57k clicks with 190k impression, and the average CTR was 1.9%. And if I scroll down, I can see the queries specific to this page only. So my page showed up for all of these keywords showing up here, right? Similarly, we have other filters. We can read the report based on the country, based on the device, and based on the search appearance. If you click on search appearance, you will see we have review snippet, product snippets, translated results, and videos. Now, review snippet is the star ratings. So if I go to this tab here with the WP Engine SSH keyword, you can see that my link has this review snippet. This is called search engine result pages, rich snippet, right? So if I filter out my report, I click on apply. You can see due to this rich snippet feature, I got 268K clicks. So all of these keywords and all of these pages are being clicked due to the rich snippet, due to the review results which I have showing up here. Like on this one, I have 6 stars out of 5 stars, right? So that's what we called review snippet. I have created a detailed video on how you can add a review snippet on your Shopify website and on your WordPress website. Subscribe to my channel if you want to learn more about how you can add a rich snippet. I'm going to remove this filter out. And now let's talk about how we can add our website to Google Search Console. Again, I have created a detailed video separately for the WordPress and for the Shopify. And in this video, I'm going to do a little small overview of how you can add your website, right? So let's click on this dropdown here and then click on add property. And from here, you're going to add your website, right? In my case, I can simply add this website here. This is my website. So I'm going to simply type it in. Now, I have already added this website. So I'm just giving you an example of how it's going to work. So you can see when you add your website to this link, all you have to do is just add this HTML tag to the head section of your website. Now, no matter you have a Shopify website or you have a WordPress website, in case of WordPress, you will go to your theme files and find the head tag and copy this tag below the head. In case of Shopify, you will go to theme.liquid file, and within that theme.liquid file under head, you will add this meta tag. And once you add that, wait for 2 to 3 minutes in order to propagate that tag. And once you do that, click on verify. Once you do click on verify, you will have this property showing up like this, like I have here for websensepro.com. Also guys, in order to index your website, once you have your property created, all you will do is click on the sitemaps. And from sitemap, you will add your sitemap URL. So in my case, you can see I have submitted my sitemap URL, which is sitemap_index.xml. In the case of Shopify, you will have sitemap.xml. Again, I have created a separate video for WordPress and Shopify in detail on how you can create Google Search Console, install that on WordPress and Shopify, and submit the sitemap. I'll add the link of those videos in YouTube video description, so you can learn more if you want to learn about adding the sitemap and verifying the Google Search Console. Other than that, we have this inspect any URL. So if you have lots of URL on the website and you don't know if that website is being indexed by Google or not, you can simply add in that URL on this inspect any URL section and then press enter to, and it will display all of the information about that URL, right? So what I'm going to do, I'll add my main URL, which is websciencepro.com, and I'm going to show you how it's going to look like. So once I inspect that and hit enter, you can see that it's giving me a green arrow that URL is on Google. If your URL is not on Google and you inspect that URL, it's going to give you that URL is not on Google and you won't see this green color arrow. And you have all further details showing up that what is the page indexing, how this is being referred on different pages. Whether if it's HTTPS or whether if it has breadcrumb, and this is the review snippet thing, which shows that what are the ratings which I have added on this page. Again, I showed you guys the example of review snippet. That's the review snippet. I have also created a video for how you can add the review snippet and how you can rank your website on top. If you want to learn how to add the review snippet, I'll add the link in the description and you will also see this video on somewhere around the screen, which will help you add the review snippet and help you rank your website on top using this review snippet trick, which is a really great trick in order to improve the SEO of your website. And that's it for the overview of Google Search Console. If you want to watch more videos like this, let me know in the comments below. And if you want me to create a similar video for Google Analytics, let me know in the comments below. Until next video, have a great day.